But you're all invited to eat out and make your meal count in September.
TV personality and chef Andrew Zimmern has joined the No Kid Hungry campaign to help end childhood hunger in America. He is live now. Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Well, can you tell us how we can help in this effort this month? How does this program work?
Well, it's really very simple. We have a national crisis, an epidemic. It's beyond shameful. I think it's criminal. 1 in 5 children in America are hungry. The best way that we have found to help fight this, and the simplest way, is to align yourself with, I think, to be the gold standard organization in fighting this fight, which is NoKidHungry.org. Every September, as kids go back to school, No Kid Hungry launches an activation called Dine Out for No Kid Hungry. 15,000 restaurants across the country are participating in this, hundreds if not thousands in the greater St. Louis area, a thousand certainly in the state of Missouri. All people have to do is go to NoKidHungry.org, type in their zip code into a small box, and it will automatically explode with restaurant options. You go, you can donate at the restaurant. Some restaurants are taking a portion of proceeds. Some restaurants are doing matching funds. Some restaurants are doing donations themselves. All types of mechanisms, but simply by participating, dollars flow back to NoKidHungry.org. NoKidHungry.org takes those dollars and uses each single dollar to create 10 meals to put into the system, mostly at schools around the country, to feed kids that aren't getting breakfast, lunch, after school snacks, and to help families with education about how to maximize their food dollars and put healthy, nutritious food on their family's table. I don't think there's a better thing that someone can do with their money or their time than support NoKidHungry.org.
Now, I know Jennifer Kaliba is there with the organization as well. Jennifer, tell us what this does to help you guys out and to help you keep things going for people who we know desperately need that assistance.
Absolutely. Well, 1 in 5 kids in the United States is going to struggle with hunger this year. 1 in 5 kids in Missouri will struggle with hunger. And when you dine out and donate, and you donate that $1, that can turn into 10 meals for kids around the country. And how we do that is we work with schools and communities to make sure that kids are getting breakfast in the classroom, where we know that it's going to make a huge difference for their outcomes in life. They're going to do better on tests. They're going to miss less school. They're ultimately going to have a better chance at graduating, reaching their full potential. And then we work in the summertime with summer meals programs so that kids during the hungriest time of the year, when school is out but hunger is absolutely in, that is when we're reaching more and more kids throughout the country. And then, as Andrew said, we're talking to families so that they can learn how to cook and how to shop and do so healthily, and how to really stretch your dollar to make it last. Because hunger in the United States, it may look a little different from what you might expect. We have families that, for the first 3 weeks of the month, they're doing okay, but on that fourth week, the money just isn't there. We have moms who are skipping meals so their kids can eat, empty pantries. It's just a solvable issue. And when we come together and we dine out for No Kid Hungry, that money is going into the system that's gonna help change that for so many more kids.
All right, so let me ask Andrew, from your standpoint, how does it make you feel to know you're a part of something? I mean, you're so involved with food itself as your job. What do you think this does to you for you personally?
Well, it's extremely fulfilling. I mean, I believe that especially those like me who have very large platforms. I mean, I have television programs that air in 70 countries, one of the largest food websites in the country. I touch a lot of people every single day across social media as well. If I'm not using my platform for a good cause or good causes, what an insufficient life. I think that everybody who is as lucky as I am should be fighting this fight. You know, I also have a unique perspective on it. First of all, 25 years ago, before I got sober, I was a homeless street junkie and alcoholic. So I took meals at Salvation Armies. I didn't know where my next meal came from. A lot of times I didn't care, but I've lived this problem in a very, very profound way. In my travel life, I'm often in third, fourth, and fifth world countries. I mean, sometimes I'm in countries that aren't even really countries. And I've noticed that there is next to no hunger program the further away from civilization that you get, because or there's no hunger issue the further away from civilization you get, because people are very self-sufficient. We have been 1,000 years ago, people, you know, hunted for their meals, they farmed, they gathered, they foraged. Today, we've marginalized so many in our society. We've created shame and stigma around hunger in America, a culture that is just gimme, 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 more, more, more. We've created this problem, and I think it's something that we have to tear down those walls and solve this issue. We waste 40% of the food in our country. We can solve the issue. We have enough food. It's getting the food onto the plates of the people that need it.
All right, Andrew Zimmern and Jennifer Kaleba, thank you so much for sharing your passion and your purpose with us. We really appreciate it.
Thank you.
We will.